Appearing before the Legal Committee of Parliament today, Law Society members argue that the competence of court martials is questionable in cases of torture, adding that the bill seemed to be protective on the perpetrators of torture, who are often serving officers.
The reason why we are recommending trial of soldiers in the civil courts is because normally these are the state actors this bill is trying to deal with. And we have noticed that the state actors are normally the biggest victims and the biggest perpetrators of torture. So we believe taking them to the court martials per se would not deal with this particular crime of a special nature.
The other recommendation in the just tabled anti-torture bill last week in Parliament is a call for privacy of torture victims where court deems fit for a hearing to proceed without the media.
E.g. in cases involving the children where there has been sexual exploitation, among others, just to mention but a few. Mr. Chairman, we are careful to make this recommendation because we have noticed that sometimes the media is requested to get out of court proceedings. But I think this should be exercised in exceptional circumstances, as we have here given examples.
It has also been argued that the bill should make it criminal for anyone to give false information in cases under investigations.
Mr. Chairman, we are all aware about our society we live in. Sometimes false information is given to the detriment of reputation. And that's why we go down to not leave this untouched. We feel it's an important item as Ugandan Law Society.
Elsewhere, journalists under the umbrella of Uganda Journalists Association have signed a memorandum of understanding with the Uganda Human Rights Commission, stipulating how the two bodies will operate. The MOU is aimed at helping journalists with a clear avenue through which they can report all cases of violence while on duty.
Let's make this work. Let this be a beginning of making a difference in our relation.
We realize we have not exploited our relationship with the media simply because there has been no structured arrangement to do that. So this memorandum of understanding gives us an opportunity of that structured arrangement on which our relationship can be functionally based.
We have a weakness. We report about other people's rights sometimes and forget to report about our rights. Now, this document is all inclusive. It looks at the areas pertaining our own rights as journalists.
On several occasions, journalists have been tortured while on duty by both security agencies and members of the public. Julius Senkandwa, NTV.